Okay, I got something awesome to share with y'all tonight. I finally found a copy of that Sherlock Holmes consulting detective game, and I've worked for hours to get it to work. So let me show it to you. I have to run it with a Sega CD emulator. It's called Tay Fusion, and load Sega CD image and then click on Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective Volume 1. It's an ISO file. And I get my trusty pad to start the game. And there it is. Awesome. That's so incredible. Let's start it. We'll see Holmes' introduction, which is a good place to start. I won't play all of it, but I'll play part of it.
London
It's
is
kind of
not the
pixelated,
usual
but
place.
this came out in 1992.
Under the
This was
soot
like the
covered buildings is a teeming
birthplace
mass
of
of 4 million
CD
souls trying to
video
survive,
games.
mostly off of each other. You see it in the paper every day.
This was
Thankfully, we
groundbreaking
have the
in
London Times to
1992.
keep us informed of all these troubling activities with an unbiased eye and razor-sharp accuracy. We find this publication to be of invaluable assistance in our investigations,
the Times,
and I'm sure
London
you will
Times.
as well. Among the forces of evil which run rampant in this city, there are also, thankfully, two groups of individuals who will aid us in our cause. As we do, they attempt to right wrongs and restore harmony and civility to the streets of London. The first of these groups is a ragtag association of young ruffians. I call them the Baker Street Irregulars. Don't let them fool you. They may be scruffy and ill-bred, but they are on the right side of the law. They can go everywhere, see everything, and overhear everyone. They are my eyes and ears in the streets of London, unquestionably a tremendous asset in our work. They will help us in our investigations if they can. The other group is a far more civilized collection of gentlemen and institutions.
Regulars.
I call them the Baker Street Regulars. They, too, will be extremely useful in our work. At the start of any investigation, do keep in mind that it is a capital mistake to theorize before one has data. Unwittingly, one begins to twist facts to suit theories instead of theories to suit facts. The people and places to whom I will now introduce you will help us to collect the facts. May we use them wisely. Come, the game's afoot.
The game is afoot. I'm so overjoyed that this is working. Well, I'll close that. I got something else neat to show you before I get out of here. We're going to close down this game. I have a game from 1996. It came out when Windows 95 was the big thing. And I've got it running on my computer. It's Star Wars Rebellion. I played this game for hours and hours. My grandmother was still living, and I was playing this over at her house with a little laptop that the university had loaned to me. But let me show this to you. I got it running. This is an awesome treat to have. I played the shit out of this game.
Mm-hmm.
we'll skip that to the game. Hard to believe this came out in 1996. And I play this on a little dinky laptop.
I am C-3PO Human Cyborg Relations, and this is my counterpart, R2-D2. We have prepared a report on the current state of the galaxy. As you can see on the galactic information display, the galaxy is in a state of turmoil. Our recent destruction of the Death Star has drawn many core systems to the Alliance cause. However, as you can see, many systems still remain loyal to the Empire. Several of the core systems are controlled by the Empire because the planets are garrisoned by Imperial.
We'll close that out. I just wanted to show y'all that. It's pretty neat. And I'll get this up on the web pretty soon.